held me back when I tried to move on from your life. So you stole my life, but clearly. So hold me back, now you're here. Cause I'm mad, show no fear. Wanna let you know just how it felt.
And welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hello, my name is Katie. I live in Orlando and I make Shop With Me videos, which can include Target Tuesdays, Shop With Me at all your favorite stores like Walmart, Home Goods, Marshalls, TJ Maxx. Sometimes I do grocery videos like this. I like to sprinkle in lots of home decor as well. So if you love videos like that, definitely make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. And while you're down there, hit the subscribe button down below. I'm really excited about today's video. This has been
highly requested.
You guys always wanna see Trader Joe's Shop With Me videos, Trader Joe's food hauls, what's new at Trader Joe's. So today is the day I'm delivering. I went to shop at Trader Joe's. Trader Joe's has so many fun seasonal items for all the seasons, but especially right now for summer. I saw lots of like fun like Mexican street corn flavored items, watermelon infused products, really fun stuff like that. So definitely I want you to leave me a comment down below with what are your favorite items to try at Trader Joe's throughout all the seasons. If you are a Trader Joe's fanatic, you will know that they bring most of their popular items back. So definitely leave me a comment down below with items that I need to try coming up in like the fall or the winter, like the peppermint Trader Jojo's, which is like a peppermint Oreo basically. But definitely let me know down below what are some of your favorite products, whether they be products that have been discontinued, things you hope they bring back. Just tell me what I need to try at Trader Joe's. Cause when I go, I'm normally stuck in a rut. I typically buy like the same things. So let me know down below what new awesome products you think I should try. Trader Joe's does not allow video in the store with sound. There was like a really specific sign. So I wanted to go ahead and respect their rules. I did not want to get kicked out of Trader Joe's. So I just filmed a little montage for you guys of me shopping in the store. Just little items that I found, items that I picked up, things like that. So let's go ahead and roll the montage and then we will go ahead and get into the haul.
You said that you needed me. Like a cargo, you will carry me. I just hope you know my depth, even though it makes no sense. Sometimes I'm broken, too much of emotions. Sometimes I'm delighted, don't wanna pick a fight with it. Everything seems so good. I guess I can't.
Let's go ahead and get into the haul. I'm gonna start off with cold items because I really need to get these in the fridge. It's been a minute since I put them in my car and then it's like a 30-minute drive home. So I really wanna go through these cold items with you first so that I can get those put away. I do wanna say that I got 4 bags of stuff and spent around $170. I just feel like I buy like the priciest stuff ever. But let's go ahead and get in. It's a mix of like new summer items, things that are seasonal. So I'll definitely let you know which items those are. But let's go ahead and get into the haul. Okay, the first item, I'm just gonna grab like whatever's on on the top is this spicy hummus. It doesn't say like what it is spicy with, but I do see that it has like jalapeno peppers, things like that. So I'm excited to eat this, and I got some fun stuff that I'll be able to dip this in. I do want to mention too, we have like friends coming over, so I did get a lot of items for like barbecue items or hosting type food. So you'll see like a lot of dips and things like that. But this is the first item that I picked up. The next item is this Genova pesto. So this is like the Trader Joe's Genova pesto. This is the one that they keep in the fridge. Typically I buy the one that's in the aisle, and then once I open it, I just put it in the fridge. But I wanted to try this one. I don't want to tell you exactly yet what I'm gonna use it for, because you might be able to figure out a couple items down the line. The next thing I picked up was this pesto chicken. Kind of goes in line with the pesto. I really like pesto. It's the besto. Anyways, so I really like pesto, so it's just sliced in half, scallopini style chicken pesto. I thought maybe we could eat it with like couscous or something like that. It has a lot of sauce, so you could even do like pasta. We don't really eat too much pasta, but this would be really, really good with pasta for sure. Next up, you will have definitely seen this in the montage. This is my favorite Trader Joe's item, and Brian doesn't even really like it that much, so I got two more for me, but it's the creamy cauliflower jalapeno dip. It's like ricotta-y, creamy, a little bit like spicy. It's so good. Brian doesn't think it has a lot of flavor, but I love it. So like I said, more for me. I did get a few different things I can dip in here, but you could also do it with like broccoli or like bell peppers or something like that, even carrots. This is just so good on everything, and I'm definitely gonna crack this open the second I'm done filming this video behind the scenes. Just jumping around, this is super random, but I got two of the kettle cooked chicken soups. I love their prepared soups. I'm just like a huge soup person, and these are really, really good, and they're also really healthy. Brian and I are trying to be healthy because, you know, we started dating in the beginning of the pandemic, and then we were quarantining together, and also we were like so happy in a new relationship, but now it's time to get our lives back on track. So I'm excited to be able to grab things like this that are pretty healthy. I could easily eat this whole thing in one sitting. I'm obsessed with soup. Okay, back on the cheese train, I got some grated pecorino romano. You can honestly put this on a lot of different stuff. It's just delicious, and it's a really good thing to have. It doesn't go bad for like literally ever, and this whole thing is $6.59. I find it difficult to find grated cheese like in the regular grocery store, like in Publix, so I try to pick this up when I go to Trader Joe's, so had to get another one because we are almost out. I think maybe the last cheese item I got is, this is our favorite cheese. This is the creamy Toscano, and it is like in Syrah, so if you see like on the bottom, oh my god, this cheese is so good. It is not mild in flavor, I would say, so if you only like cheddar cheese, you probably wouldn't like this, but maybe you would. Honestly, I don't know. I just love all cheeses except for blue cheese, so definitely try this if you like cheese. And then their seasonal one right now is the rosé one. I decided to go with the one that I know and love because I don't go to Trader Joe's that often, but I am so excited to eat some of this. My mouth is literally watering. Okay, I think that's it for all the cheeses. The next item I got was Brussels sprouts. I love Brussels sprouts. My favorite way to cook them is air fried with a little bit of the spray olive oil, and then you can do Italian seasoning and then some breadcrumbs. I know it's gonna sound really weird, but just toss it all together, throw it in the air fryer, and then let them get crispy and eat them with marinara. I know that's gonna sound so, so weird, but I promise you it is so delicious. We're probably gonna end up eating these tonight because we're both obsessed. He didn't like Brussels sprouts, I don't think, until he had my Brussels sprouts, so definitely recommend trying them. Like I said, cut them up. It depends on how big the Brussels sprout is, but normally like half or a quarter, and then you just air fry them with a little bit of breadcrumbs, olive oil spray, Italian seasoning, salt and pepper to taste, and then dip them in marinara sauce. So good. Next up, we have some ground turkey, 99% lean, 1% fat. Great for like turkey burgers, or you can cook it with taco seasoning and have some tacos. I don't really do beef. I started eating meat in September. If you're new here, I was vegetarian for a really long time. Just started eating meat again in September, and I don't really do like much beef. We do a lot of like turkey, chicken, and pork. So this is great for like tacos, turkey burgers, just a really good thing to have. Speaking of chicken, I got 5 packs of these drumsticks, and I did get some packs of wings as well. These are, I felt like, a pretty decent price. It was $3 for 5 huge drumsticks. I don't really like chicken wings, but like I said, we are having friends over this weekend, so this is such an easy thing to like throw on the grill, perfect for the summer. So I got a bunch of packs of these, and then I got a really, really yummy marinade that I'm gonna show you in a little bit that'll be perfect to go on these, and I'm really excited about it. It's one of Trader Joe's new seasonal items. Okay, I lied, I found more cheese. I got this mozzarella cheese log, so it's already pre-sliced. So I guess since I've already showed you the pesto and now this, I will show you I got a ciabatta baguette. I am planning on making bruschetta, so later in this video you will see tomatoes and a couple other yummy things for the bruschetta. I've never made it, but I just feel like this makes it super easy. This is already pre-sliced, so once I slice the bread and like prepare all the other stuff for it, I just feel like this is gonna be so yummy, so fresh for the summer, so delicious. I'm obsessed with bruschetta and like burrata and like anything like that. So I'm really, really excited to try to make it on my own. Next up, we have a couple fruits and vegetables. Like I said, I got tomatoes, so I picked up this mixed medley cherry tomato. I Googled like what tomatoes are good for bruschetta, and those were the ones that recommended, so I decided to pick those up. Everything at Trader Joe's is honestly such a good price, so I think this was only like $3, and this is a bunch of tomatoes. Also grabbed a thing of blueberries. Brian is absolutely obsessed with blueberries. I'm not a fan, I think they taste muddy. So definitely let me know if you are a fan of blueberries or not. I like blueberry flavored things, and I don't mind them in a smoothie, but I wouldn't just like eat them. I don't like them like that. And then I also grabbed a thing of super sweet corn, perfect for the grill for tomorrow when our friends come over. Moving right into the frozen items, I'm gonna go through these pretty quickly. I got these Brownie Crisp coffee ice cream sandwiches. These look amazing, and they're not that unhealthy for you. Not that honestly I really care that much, but these looked really good, and I figured it'd be fun to try. We're obsessed with the Yasso bars as well as the Yasso ice cream sandwiches. So I thought this would be a fun little like different thing to have because it's super similar to a Yasso ice cream sandwich. So really, really excited to try these later tonight for sure. The next item are the chili lime burgers. I've never tried these, but I've heard good things. Figured these would make like super easy lunches or like dinners in a pinch or something like that. So I decided to grab these. You get four of them, and these were only like $3.50. So I felt like it was a really good deal because it's less than a dollar a patty. Another little patty item that I love are these cauliflower pancakes. These are really, really good for like breakfast. Like if you do like a piece of avocado toast with egg and whatever, and then like these on the side, or these could be like the base of the avocado toast. These are really, really tasty. They're kind of like potato pancakes, but I think they're a little bit healthier, and these are delicious in the air fryer. And then the last frozen item that I picked up was the brown rice. I love having this on hand for the dogs. If they ever start to not feel good, it's really easy to be able to just throw these in the microwave, and I just think they're a little bit better than the ones from the grocery store, like at Publix or whatever in the frozen section. So I decided to pick these up. They're just super easy, and one of the bags will feed all three of our dogs, like on top of whatever else we're giving them. But these are just really good to have on hand in case your dog ever gets like a stomach ache. It's really good to like bind everything in their stomach and help, you know, make them feel better. I did not even realize how much stuff I got. Okay, moving into like the chippy stuff. Speaking of the dogs, I will get this one out of the way. I got these beef recipe jerky strips. I'm sure they will love them. Maybe I'll include a little clip at the end of them taste testing them, but I know that they would like these, and I just saw them and I wanted to get them a little treat as well. I wasn't kidding when I said I got a lot of chippy items. I don't know if it's just me or if it's like because of my family, but like I just am obsessed with like chippy type snacky stuff. I like can't eat lunch without having like some sort of like crunchy chip type item. And they have a lot of really fun options at Trader Joe's. The first one that is right here that I'm really excited to try, I've actually never tried these, are these elote corn chip dippers. I've heard really good things about these, and they have a Mexican style street corn flavored seasoning, and it says that they're really good with guacamole. That's what's in the picture, but I'm gonna try them with my cauliflower dip. Maybe I'll taste test it on camera, but I've heard really good things about these, so I'm super excited to try them. I also picked up a bag of the reduced guilt kettle cooked potato chips. They're just like less fat than regular potato chips, and I don't really ever see the difference, so decided to pick these up. I'm obsessed with like tuna fish sandwiches, and to me you cannot eat a tuna fish sandwich without potato chips in the sandwich. Okay, bye. The next item I decided to pick up were these vegetable chips. These are really, really good with hummus. They didn't have the garlic hummus, so that's why I decided to go with like the spicy one, but the Trader Joe's garlic hummus is so good with these, as well as these, which are the pretzel sticks. These are the honey wheat ones. Both of these are really good with hummus, honestly any flavor of hummus, so I'm really excited to try the spicy hummus that I got. But both of these are really, really good. I highly recommend, especially these. So good with any type of dip. Okay, the next bag is a doozy. This has so much random stuff in it, so I'm just gonna start pulling stuff out. The first items are low sodium chicken broth. Like I said, I love soup. Ryan also loves soup. We make soup a lot, like really sporadically, so this is just really good to have in case we ever wanna make soup, or I'll make pastina if you guys have ever had pastina. I think it's like a Northeast Italian thing. I have no idea. Not like Northeast Italy, but like Northeastern USA Italian thing. Because it's just like pasta, the pastina pasta, and then you just cook it in this, and then I put an egg in it and whisk it up. If you've never had that, you probably think it sounds disgusting. It's super, super bland, but it's just comfort food. The next thing I grabbed is actually what we're gonna use for our chicken wings. So this is the organic sweet and spicy pineapple barbecue sauce. This is new for the summer. I'm really excited to try it. They said that it would be really good on chicken wings. They didn't have a lot of other like marinade type options. I definitely don't think Trader Joe's is a one-stop shop, but it is a really good and fun place to shop because they have a lot of really cool, unique items for each season. So I decided to pick this up for the chicken wings, and I'm really excited to try it. You guys know over here we are obsessed with everything pineapple, so I'm sure this will be delicious. I also decided to grab two of these sparkling ginger and lemon apple cider vinegar beverages. We haven't been doing it recently, but we love to do like apple cider vinegar shots with like ginger and lemon or whatever. It's just super healthy, really helps like alkalize your body so you don't get sick. It's a really good immune booster. So I figured we could try this, and they're sparkling, so it looks pretty good. I figured we could give it a whirl. Keeping with the beverages, I decided to pick up this jalapeno limeade. This to me does not sound good, but I thought Brian might like it as like a margarita mixer or something. He loves margaritas, and this just sounded like the perfect little margarita in a bottle. Just add tequila. And I saw people raving about it on like TikTok and stuff, so I wanted to go ahead and pick this up. It was one of the last few bottles that they had, so I'm really excited that I picked this up. And make sure you follow me on Instagram at Katie Vining if you want to see like reviews and what I think about a lot of this stuff, because that will be more like in the moment stuff that you can find on my Instagram. So make sure you go ahead and follow me there. The next few items are kind of like baking pantry type items. I think they have a really, really amazing prices on some specific stuff. Maple syrup is one of them. I'm an absolute maple syrup snob. I grew up in Massachusetts, where like every year you go on a field trip with school where you go tap trees and make your own maple syrup. And we just don't really use like log cabin or like buttermilk Bisquick syrup or anything like that up there. So I'm a maple syrup snob, and I think that Trader Joe's has really good maple syrup. This big bottle was like $7.99, which if you like the more like corn syrupy maple syrup flavored type products, then that will seem really expensive to you. But this is really, really good, and they have like different grades. This is grade A, dark and robust. They also have like amber, so if you like a more maple-y flavored maple syrup, they have a couple different options. I like it as dark as I can find it, as maple-y and like true tasting as I can get it. And this one is super good. A couple years ago, they also had this like maple syrup like tasting sampler, and it was like four like mini bottles, and they got like darker in color. So there was like light, medium, amber, and then like dark. Oh my gosh, they were amazing. That was super fun, all really good quality syrup. I don't know if they'll be bringing that back this fall, but hopefully. But until then, you can definitely find some awesome maple syrup at Trader Joe's. I definitely recommend checking it out. Another great pantry staple that they have at a really good price is this pure bourbon vanilla extract. This vanilla extract is like the secret to good cookies. And vanilla extract, you don't want to get like vanilla flavoring. You really want to get vanilla extract, and pure vanilla extract is very, very expensive, especially depending on where you go. This is a really good size bottle. This will last me a long time, and this was under $10, and it's like vanilla bourbon, so it just, it has a lot of really good flavors, and it's not something you're gonna find at a regular grocery store. So items like this are the reason I go to Trader Joe's every once in a while to restock on my favorite staples, and this is definitely one of them. Another staple from Trader Joe's that I love is their balsamic glaze. This is going to be perfect for my bruschetta that I'm gonna make. I'm just gonna drizzle it over the top. This is also really good if you drizzle it over like pizza or the Brussels sprouts that I love. It's so good on everything, just a little balsamic glaze. They do sell products like this at the grocery store as well, but I just always buy the Trader Joe's one, and this stuff seriously lasts forever. We're getting down to the last few items. The next one I just got is garlic powder. Super simple, but we needed garlic powder. All we had was garlic salt, and I just wanted like regular garlic powder, and their spices are a really, really good price, so just picked up some garlic powder. I saved two really fun items for last. They are in the summer line. I got this watermelon facial mist as well as this watermelon overnight mask. I work from home and a lot of times I don't wear makeup, so I can just like wear this all day and then like wash my face before I go to bed. But it's just gonna be super, super hydrating. These are dupe products for things you can find at Sephora for a lot more. But my sister added me to some like weird Facebook skincare groups and people were raving about these, so I was really excited when I saw that they still had them. I thought for sure that they would be sold out of a lot of the summer products, but I was able to find almost everything I was looking for, so I was super pumped to find these two items for sure. Again, if you wanna know like what I think about them, I need to use them a little bit first before I let you know, but definitely follow me over on my Instagram so you can see what I end up thinking about these after I've had time to test them out. Alrighty, you guys, that is gonna be it for me today. Sorry if the lighting got a little bit weird. We have like a storm rolling in, so you can see it's getting darker on this side and still light over there. Classic Florida, but that is gonna be it for me today. I really hope that you enjoyed seeing a Trader Joe's haul. You guys requested it, so I really hope that you enjoy it. Definitely let me know down below if you wanna see me do other grocery stores or potentially even get like a Costco membership or something. We've been thinking about it, so definitely let me know down below if you'd want to see those types of videos from me. That is gonna be it for me. If you haven't yet, definitely make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button down below, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys. It's blooper time. I'm really excited to try these. Oh, they kind of smell like Fritos. These like elote chips. God, come to mama. I'm obsessed with this stuff. Cauliflower jalapeno dip with these elote dippers. Yep. Oh my God. Highly recommend this combo. Guys, who wants a treat? Treat, treat. Puppies assemble. Sit. Sit. Okay, spin. 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 Okay. One for you. One for you. White, sit. Good boy. Enjoy.